Welcome to the another chapter, that is revenue function. We already discussed about the production function. We already discussed about the cost function. Now we are going to discuss about the revenue function. The purpose of revenue function is to understand how much we are earning, and to earn that much of money, how much we are producing or how much we are selling. Sometime, you know, sell going beyond your capacity, it is not going to add extra profit. So you are going to sell that much amount of profit where your marginal revenue or your extra revenue is maximum. Beyond that, when your marginal revenue is getting negative, you need to stop the further selling. Now the sale is depend upon in what type of market structure you are operating. So without wasting much of our time, we are now going to discuss about the revenue function. So let us start the revenue function. Revenue function, first of all, in revenue function, we have to understand the meaning of the word revenue. So normally people believe revenue means, something related to profit. So they believe revenue means it is profit or something like that, but it is not like profit, because that is a misconception that the people used to carry with them. So revenue is not equal to profit. Now the question may arise, that then what is the meaning of the revenue? So let us understand, the revenue means total amount of sales. So when there is a sales that you are doing, it is known as revenue. Normally in accounting, what happened when you are making an account for the non-profit organization? So non-profit organization is not selling anything, they are actually selling their services. So instead of saying sales, they will say revenue. So you can say these two are the substitute of each other. Now the sales is what? For example, when you are going to a grocery shop and you purchase 10 packets of milk, and each packet of milk is costing you 5 rial, so how much sell? It is 50 rial. So this 50 rial is the total amount of sale, or you can say it is the revenue. So sales is nothing but the quantity, that is how much you are purchasing, multiplied by the price per product. So you will get the sales, or you will get the revenue. So understood about the concept of revenue? Now revenue is depend upon market structure. For example, there are two type of market. One and two. In the first type of market, it is known as perfect competition. The second type of market structure is known as monopoly. Under the perfect competition, in this particular type of market structure, you can increase the sales by reducing the price. So what is going to happen? You have to decrease the price to increase the revenue or sales. But in second type of market is a monopoly market. Here you can increase the sales, but you are not changing your price. So let's take the example. Let's say we are making a table 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 column table, and let us assume that our market is a perfect competitive market. Under the perfect competitive market, you are increasing the revenue by reducing the price. So let's say this is the price, it is 10 real, 9 real, 8 real, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. So you are decreasing the price so that you can increasing the quantity of sales. Now what is sales? We already know. What is the total revenue? How you are going to count the total revenue? It is nothing but the price multiplied by the quantity sold. So it is 10 into 1. So it is 10. Then it is 9 into 2, so it is 18. Then it is 8 into 3, so it is 24. Same way, 28, 30, 30, 28 and 24. Now you need to calculate what is your marginal revenue. Marginal means what? Extra or additional. Last time we discussed in greater detail what is marginal. Now you look, this is 18 and earlier you were earning 10. So how much 8 is extra? Here it is 24, you are earning 18. So how much extra you are earning? Let's say 6 real extra. Here it is 28, earlier it was 24. So 4 real extra. Then this is 30 minus 28, so 2 real extra. Then 30 minus 30, so 0, minus 2 and minus 4. AR is very easy to calculate. AR is equal to TR divided by quantity. So 10 divided by 1, it is 10. Then 18 divided by 2, so it is 9. Then 24 divided by 8, so it is 8. Now, if you see very closely, the price and AR are same. 10, 10, 9, 9, 8, 8, 7, 7, 6 is. So the question may arise, why it is same? Because when you are calculating the total revenue is nothing but price into quantity. And when you are writing AR, AR means TR multiplied by divided by quantity. So AR is, instead of TR, I can write P into Q. So P into Q divided by Q, Q, Q get cancelled. So what is happening? AR is equal to price. Another important thing is that now you just look at here, AR is decreased from 10 to 9, 1, 9 to 8, A1, 8 to 7, 1, 7 to 6, 1, 6 to 5, 1, 5 to 4, 1, and 4 to 3, 1. Now what happened here? It is 8 to 6, it is 2, 6 to 4, 2, 4 to 2, 2, 2 to 0, 2, 2 to minus 1, minus 2, 2 to minus 4, minus 2. So AR and MR relationship. So when AR is decreased by 1, MR is decreased by double. Double than AR. So please keep this relation in mind. So when AR is decreased by 1, then MR is decreased by 2. So MR is decreasing double than AR. TR, AR and MR graph, perfect competition. Now let us look at the graph. If you look at the graph of TR, look at that graph of TR. Now you see 10, 18, 24, everything it's going at the high and then it will go down. So this is your TR graph. It is going up and then it will go down. This is actually wrong. So this is TR graph. First it will go up and then it remains same. And then it will go down. So there are three stages. First it is increasing, then it remains same, and then it goes down. Now if I make the MR and TR graph, let's say if I want to make the MR graph, let's say this is MR graph, then what is going to happen? This is X axis, this is MR. So what happened? MR, if you look at the MR, it is going down. MR which is going down and becomes zero and negative. So what happened? The MR will go down and becomes zero. Whereas AR is also going down, but it never becomes zero. So this is AR. Now let us understand the AR and MR graph under the monopoly, or under the monopoly how you are going to make the AR table, a revenue function table. So let's say 1 2 3 4 5, our quantity is increasing, but you look at the price, our price remain same, so we are not changing the price, and TR is nothing but P into Q. So it is 1 into 10 10, 2 into 10 20, 3 into 10 it is 30. So TR is also increasing. AR means, as we discussed, AR is equal to 2 P into Q divided by Q, so QQ cancel, so AR is equal to price. So it is 10 10 10 10 every time. Now you look at the MR, it is 20 minus 10, so it is 10. Then this is 30 minus 20, so it is 10. 40 minus 30, so this is also 10. So what happened? AR, MR and price. Price, AR and MR are same in a monopoly market structure. The TR is increasing. Look, this is our TR, which is constantly increasing. And if you look at the graph of AR is equal to MR is equal to price, because they are all same. Now look at the exercise. There are mainly dash categories of market. There are two, perfect competition and monopoly. There are dash stages of total revenue. So if you look at the perfect competition, the total revenue is increasing, then remains same, and it is going down. It is the first phase, TR is increasing at an increasing rate. In the second stage, TR is maximum and MR is zero. Remember, when MR is zero, TR is always maximum. In the third stage, total revenue is and MR is. In the third stage, the total revenue is falling and MR is negative. The rate of fall in MR is double than AR. In exam, you will be asked to prepare a revenue table considering the market structure is a perfect competition, and then you have to make TR, AR and MR graph. In a similar manner, you may be asked to prepare a revenue table for monopoly market structure, and you have to make TR, AR and MR graph, which we already discussed. So this is the entire chapter on revenue function. So please understand that we studied the production function, cost function and of course a revenue function. So these three functions are very, very important, because there is always a comparison of the cost with production. There is a comparison between the cost and the revenue, and you are going to take the most appropriate decision. So this is all about the economics. In the next lecture, we are going to discuss about the different types of market. Thank you very much.